Good morning, everyone. Let us start with today's session. So this is lecture number one of the engineering mechanics. I am Omkar Sarvi, assistant professor in the mechanical engineering department. As this is your first day for your engineering curriculum, so I welcome you all on behalf of SSPM's College of Engineering. So before we start with the subject introduction, let us see the different subjects for your semester 1 and your semester 2 of your first year. So your semester 1, you have total 5 subjects, as you can see here on the slide: the engineering physics, engineering chemistry, engineering mathematics. So these 3 subjects, physics, chemistry and mathematics, they are from the fundamental science. Then the basic electrical and electronics, that is called as a BEE subject. So this subject, it is from the electrical and electronics engineering. And the engineering mechanics subject, so this is from the mechanical engineering. So total we have 5 subjects for the semester 1. For semester 2, we have engineering physics 2, engineering chemistry 2 and engineering mathematics 2. So these are again from the fundamental science. Then C programming, this subject is from the computer engineering department. And the engineering graphics, so this subject is about the engineering drawing, it is from the mechanical engineering. So as first year is common for all the branches, so you have at least one subject from each branch, okay, that is from mechanical, computer, electrical, electronics. So as we start with the engineering mechanics subject, we will start with the introduction of this subject. So what is meaning of engineering mechanics, what are the applications of mechanics, then syllabus and the prerequisites. Okay, so let us see what is the meaning of engineering mechanics. So engineering mechanics is the branch of the physics or physical science which deals with the study of forces and the effect of the forces on the bodies which are at the rest or in the motion. So basically in the engineering mechanics, we will be dealing with the forces and their effect on the bodies. Okay, so forces, they can cause the motion of object. So we will study the motion. We will determine some motion parameters, that is a velocity, displacement, acceleration. Okay, so this study, it is called as engineering mechanics. So mechanics, this term, it was first introduced by Sir Isaac Newton in the 15th century. So the first year engineering mechanics subject, it is purely dependent on the Newtonian mechanics. So what is meaning of Newtonian mechanics? So you must have studied some laws of Newton. So Newton's law of gravity, then equations of motion and some numerical methods which are based on the Newton's method. Okay, so the total study of engineering mechanics, it will depend only on the Newtonian mechanics, and therefore sometimes the engineering mechanics, it is also called as a Newtonian mechanics. So basically Newtonian mechanics, it is applied to some macroscopic phenomena. So what is meaning of macroscopic phenomena? Suppose you throw one object with some initial velocity, and then if you want to find the final position of that object, then such type of calculation, it is called as a Newtonian mechanics, where we can use the Newton's law. So if you observe this definition, then you can see 3 important points. The first is the force, then second is the body, and third is the motion. Okay, so we will see what is meaning of force, body and what is meaning of motion. So the first point here in the definition, it is called as a force. So the definition for force is, a force is any interaction that when unopposed will change the motion of an object. So a force can change the state of rest, or it can change the state of continuous motion. So force, it can cause an object to change its velocity, that is to accelerate or decelerate. Okay, so you must have studied force concept in your 11th standard in the physics. So the force, it is classified into two major categories. The first one is contact forces and second is the non-contact forces. So this is general classification of the force. So we will get some idea what are the contact forces and what are the non-contact forces. So in the contact forces, you can see here there are total four forces. The first is the tension, that is a pull force. Second is the compression, which is called as also push force. Then friction resistance, and the last is the drag force, or it is called as a fluid friction. And in the non-contact forces, we have gravitational pull, then second is the magnetic attraction, and third is the electrostatic force. So we will see the example of the contact forces and the non-contact forces. So here you can see some pictures for the contact forces. In the first picture, you can see one person is applying some force on the table. Okay, so this force, basically it is a contact force, and it is either pull or the push force. Okay, so pull means what? In the second diagram, this is the pull force, and in the first diagram, it is the push force. Then second force, that is a contact force again, it is the tension force. So in the picture, you can see one spring is connected, and to the spring, one mass is connected. So because of the gravity, this mass will move in the downward direction, and because of that motion in the downward direction, this spring, it will undergo the deformation. So basically this spring will experience a tension force because of the mass. So this is the example for the tension force. Then third picture, it is for the friction force. So everyone knows what is meaning of friction. So if there is any relative motion between two objects in contact, then one object or one surface will offer the resistance to the motion of the other object. So this is called as friction. Okay, so here one person is pulling one box on the ground, and this ground, it will offer the resistance to the motion of the block in the opposite direction. So that is called as a friction force. And friction will exist between two objects if they are in the contact. So this is again a contact force. Then fourth diagram, it is the normal force. So normal force, you can see here example. Here object is kept on one table or surface of the table. Okay, so the surface of this table, it will offer the opposite reaction to the weight of that object. So here you can see NB, this is called as a normal reaction, and WB, it is the weight of the object. So this is the normal reaction, or the reaction which is offered by one surface to the other surface. Okay, and the last example, it is called as a drag force. So this is the example of the parachute. And last example is for the drag force. So here you can see one parachute. Okay, so parachute experience the drag force because of the air. So this is the example for the drag forces. So basically drag force, it is also a friction force, but it exists in case of the fluids. Okay, and this friction force that is shown in the third example, it exists between the two solid surfaces. Okay, so I hope this concept is clear. What is meaning of contact forces? So contact forces, in a simple language, we can see if there is a contact between two objects and the forces exist between this contact, it is called as a contact forces. Then this is the examples for the non-contact forces. So first non-contact force, it is the gravitational force, or we say this as a gravitational pull. Okay, so any object undergoes the free fall because of the gravitational acceleration. So here in the first example, you can see the apple is falling because of the gravity. Okay, then second example, it is the electrostatic or electrostatic force. So you must have performed this experiment. If you rub the ebonite stick on the wool, then it will attract some particles. Okay, so it gets positively charged and it will attract the paper particles. So this is because of the electrostatic force. And the last example, it is for the magnetic force. Okay, so these are called as non-contact forces. So the forces that exist without any physical contact, these are called as a non-contact forces. So the second point from this definition of engineering mechanics, it is the bodies. Okay, so body is another word someone can use to describe an object having some mass. So we can refer the body to very small object like a ball, a book, a small stone, and also we can refer to very large object like a heavy machine, a car, airplane, building, or a railway bridge. Okay, so these are the examples for the bodies. So here you can see some pictures. So the body, this term, you can observe this term in the Newton's first law. So what is the Newton's first law? A body or object, it remains in the state of rest or continuous motion unless and until it is acted upon by an external unbalanced force. So this is the Newton's first law. So what is exactly meaning of body? So first example, it is the football. Okay, so when a player kicks the football, it will apply some force, and because of that force, that football, it will receive some velocity and it will cover some distance. Okay, then second object here, it is an automobile. Okay, so automobile, it will remain in the static equilibrium or in the dynamic equilibrium because of the forces. So here different forces are shown on the automobile. So we can treat, for the force analysis or engineering mechanics point of view, a total automobile or a car as a body. So here you can see some forces. There are some vertical forces, okay, which will support the weight, and there are some frictional forces. So this is the static friction between tires and the road surface, and there is a FD, which is called as a fluid friction, which is offered by the air on the vehicle. Okay, then third example, so this is very common example. So this is the construction crane. Okay, so this crane, it will lift some weight, then the forces will act on this boom. So when we apply some forces, there will be some reactions. So these are the reactions at the contact point between the road surface and the tires of that crane. Then third example, this is the railway bridge. Okay, so these are some examples for the bodies. So I hope this concept is clear. What is meaning of body? It is the motion. So in the motion, we will try to find out the velocities, then distance, displacement, time, acceleration. So these are some motion parameters which are related when we apply some force on object. So in the second example, you can see a person kicks the football and it gets some velocity. So it will cover some distance with that velocity. So this calculation, it is a part of engineering mechanics. Then second example, a person travels along this curve path and it comes to the end point. Okay, so actual path covered by that person, it is called as a distance, and the difference between its final position and the initial position along the Cartesian axis, x or y or z axis, it is called as displacement. So velocity, this term, we can find out, it is a displacement divided by time. Okay, that is a ds by dt. And suppose we want to find out the acceleration, we can find out acceleration as a dv by dt, that is change in velocity by change in time. Then second parameter, which is related to the motion, it is the momentum. So momentum, it is represented as a P. It is mass into velocity. So these are all motion parameters. Okay. Basically, motion means what? When we apply some force on the object and it is moving with some velocity or acceleration, it will carry some momentum. Okay. So this is called as a motion of the object. And suppose the velocity is zero, as you can see here in the first example, this object having some mass m, okay, it is kept on the surface. Okay, so this object, it experienced two forces. One is the mg, that is the self weight, and the normal reaction which is offered by the surface. Okay, but there is no force in the x direction, that is a positive x or negative x. Therefore, there will not be any motion of this object. Okay, so this condition, it is called as a rest condition, where velocity of the object is zero. Okay, so this is called as a motion. So I hope this concept is clear. What is meaning of? Now we will see the broad classification of the engineering mechanics. So the engineering mechanics subject, it is mainly classified into two categories. One is the solid mechanics and second is the fluid mechanics. So solid mechanics, it deals with the application of forces and the motion on the solid objects, or generally we call this as a rigid bodies. And the fluid mechanics, it deals with the force calculation, then calculation of motion parameters, that is velocity, acceleration, momentum for the fluids. So solid mechanics, it is again divided into two parts. The first one is the rigid body mechanics and second one is the mechanics of deformable bodies. So everyone knows the concept for rigid body and deformable body. So what is meaning of a rigid body? If you apply some force on a body or object and if there is no deformation, this is called as a rigid body. Okay, and suppose we apply some force on object and that object undergoes some deformation, that is change in shape and size, it is called as a deformable bodies. Okay, so for first year mechanics, that is your subject engineering mechanics, it will only deal with the rigid body mechanics only. So everywhere when we will do the force analysis or motion analysis, we will assume the given object or given body as a rigid object only. Okay, that means it will not undergo any change in its shape when we apply the force. So rigid body mechanics, it is again divided into two parts. One is a static and second is the dynamics. Okay, so when we will start your subject, that is your actual syllabus, then we will see what is meaning of a static and what is meaning of dynamic. Now the second category, which is the fluid mechanics. So fluid mechanics, it is also again divided into two parts. One is a fluid static and the fluid dynamic. And the second subject, which is the mechanics of deformable bodies, where we will study the force and their effect on the bodies which will undergo the deformation. Okay, so this subject, it is again divided into two parts. One is a theory of elasticity and second is the theory of plasticity. Okay, so the total part on the right hand side, it is from the fluid mechanics, this complete part. So basically these are all subjects of the pure mechanical engineering. From second year of the mechanical engineering, students will study each subject, which is fluid mechanics, fluid static, fluid dynamic, then fluid kinematics, then mechanics of deformable bodies, then theory of elasticity and theory of plasticity. Okay, for your first year engineering mechanics, as it is common for all the branches, we will study only the rigid body mechanics. Okay, and in the rigid body mechanics specifically, we will study the static part and the dynamic part. Okay, so for the engineering mechanics subject, it is only the rigid body mechanics. So now we will see what are the applications of engineering mechanics. So engineering mechanics subject, it is useful in your day-to-day life to the rocket science. Okay, so everywhere we have to apply the concepts from the mechanics, because in the universe all the phenomena, they are based on the application of force. So if there is a force, there will be some motion. Okay, so in the engineering mechanics we will try to find out the effect of forces on the bodies. So if you apply some force on object, what will be the velocity, what will be the acceleration, okay, and how much distance it can cover. So in the application, the first application, this is a common example, which is the spanner. Okay, so you must have seen some spanner in your day to day life. So spanners, they are made of different lengths. So this is just an example. Okay, so this is having the higher length compared to this spanner. So when we design, we have to find out how much force we have to apply in order to rotate the nut. So depending on that force, we will either increase the length of the spanner or we can decrease the length of the spanner. Okay, so here we have to find out the quantity which is called as torque. So everyone knows what is meaning of torque. So torque, this quantity, it is nothing but the force into perpendicular distance, that is the d. Okay, so when we design the spanner, we must know the distance or the point of application of this force and the perpendicular distance with respect to that force. So once we know this distance and the force value, okay, we can find out the torque in order to tighten this nut or the rotate this nut. So this is one application. Then second application, again this is a common example, that is a JCB arm, or which is called as an excavator arm. So when we design the JCB arm, the initial parameters are how much load it can lift. So basically this load, it will act on this bucket of the JCB arm, okay, and then this load, it will be transmitted through this arm of the JCB. Okay, so basically the motion of this JCB arm, it will depend or controlled by these hydraulic cylinders. So these are the hydraulic cylinders. So when we design the JCB arm, we have to calculate how much force will be acting on this hydraulic cylinder. Okay, so this calculation, it involves the application of engineering mechanics. So I will show one simulation. So is the screen visible? So when engineer design the railway bridges, or which is called as a bridge truss, then we have to find out how much load or the tension forces or the compressive forces will be acting on these members. So these are called as a members. So these are the members of the bridge truss, and engineers have to find out how much forces will be acting at these joints. Okay, so this part, it is the part of the engineering mechanics, and specifically it is the part of static. So we will see this when we'll start with the actual syllabus. Okay, so I will show the simulation. and this railway bridge, it is supported by these two walls, okay, and the force is acting on this railway bridge. So because of this force, there will be some deformation of this bridge truss, okay, and as there is a deformation, when we apply the force, these members will experience either tension forces or the compressive forces, okay. So when engineer design this bridge, at the calculation part, they have to find out this forces value, okay, and depending on this force value, we can select the proper material to construct this bridge, okay. So I will run the simulation, then you can observe how the bridge will deform. Okay, so you can see here, when we apply some force on this bridge, there is a deformation of the bridge. Then the next application, it is the projectile motion. So projectile motion, you must have studied this in your TELS syllabus, that is a physics. So when we throw one object by making some angle with respect to the ground or with respect to the horizontal, then that object, it will follow the projectile path, which is basically a parabolic path, okay. So when we project some object with some initial velocity, that is V, as you can see here, okay, so for this example, velocity is 600, just take SI unit, okay. If I project any object with this velocity, how much distance it can cover along the x direction, okay. So this calculation or this distance we can find out with the help of engineering mechanics. So this application is, you can see here, on the war field, when any missile is launched by using a tank, okay, then we have to select this proper angle with respect to horizontal, okay, so that it can cover the maximum distance. So basically this angle for maximum distance, it is the 45 degree, okay. So this is the application of engineering mechanics for the projectile motion. The next application, it is the common application, which is a brake design. So for your automobile, that is your bicycle, when we apply the force, so this is the force that is applied on this brake lever. So this is the brake lever, okay. So rider, it will apply this force, and this force, it will cause the motion or the movement of this lever, and then it will transmit it to the cable. So this is the brake cable, okay, and with the help of this cable, it is transmitted to the brake caliper, which is connected to the wheel, okay, and then brake is applied. So when we design a brake lever, we have to find out how much force is required in order to grip or maintain the proper grip at the brake caliper, okay. So depending on this, we can find out this force of application, which is the F grip. So this part, it requires the force analysis, and this is the application for engineering mechanics. Then next is the automobile design. So in the automobile design, first is the design of engine, then design of suspensions, design of gearboxes, then braking mechanism, and the design of chassis. Okay, so for all this part, we require a proper force analysis. Okay, and therefore we require to study the engineering mechanics. So I will show the simulation how these forces are acting on the automobile. So you can see here. Is it visible to you? So the course structure is your engineering mechanics subject. It is divided into theory course and your lab, that is a practical. So theory course, it has a course code which is FEC 104, and for laboratory the course code is FEL. L is for the lab, it is 103. Okay, so course, that is FEC 104, we have 3 theory classes per week. Then practical, it is of 2 hours per week for each batch. Then your assessment, it is carried out as an internal assessment. So there will be 2 compulsory class tests of 20 mark each. Then for end semester theory exam, so it is the theory exam of 80 marks and weightage for module as per the number of teaching hours. Okay, so total theory weightage is 80 plus 20 marks, it is the 100 marks. So your complete syllabus or complete subject engineering mechanics, it is for the 100 marks for the theory. Then lab structure, the course code is FEL 103. So practical hours are 2 hours for each batch. Then laboratory work, it carries 20 marks. So this laboratory work is divided into assignments and the experiments. So assignments, they are based on the theory syllabus. So you will be given some problems to solve for each modules. Okay, so these are called as assignments. And experiments, this is the laboratory work. Then your attendance in the class, it carries 5 marks. So total term work, it is 20 plus 5, that is the 25 marks. And your final exam, it is the oral exam, it is for the 25 marks. Okay, so total laboratory weightage, it is 25 marks plus 25 marks, that is the 50 marks. Okay, so this oral exam, it will depend on your theory syllabus as well as your practicals. Okay, so this is your overall course structure, that is theory plus practicals.